We have Akash Dhomre with us, and I understand that you're working at Accenture as a senior analyst,
Yes.
and you've also worked as an analyst at TCS for
Yeah.
around 2 years.
Yeah.
So tell us a little about that, like about your journey and about your career path.
Yeah, sure, Rutuja, and thanks to Preplace for inviting me for this interview. Actually, I have started my
Absolutely.
journey from Indore. I have completed
Okay.
engineering in electronics and communication background from Indore, Swami Vivekananda College. And after that, I just went to Bangalore for pursuing career in the world of IT sector. Okay.
Right.
So there I just went for trainings for Java and SQL. And there
Okay.
after a lot of struggle, I got selected in IQVIA as a
Okay.
Spotfire developer. Okay. So
Okay.
at that time, I was not aware of that particular tool, that is Spotfire, that comes into data analytics field. And
Right.
when I was fresher, I was just aware of Java, testing, SQL, and all, and web HTML like that. So I was not aware of
Right.
data analytics that much. But slowly, slowly, I just got things little bit. And
Right.
after that, after 2 years working in IQVIA, Bangalore, I switched in TCS, Mumbai. And
Okay.
recently, I just switched in Accenture, Bangalore as a senior
Okay.
analyst. And I have
Right.
total 5 years of experience in world of data analytics.
Okay. That's great. That's
Yeah.
great. Okay. So I just want to know, what is your current role and your position, and what do you work on?
Yeah, actually the thing is, currently I'm working on Spotfire. That is a data
Okay.
visualization tool. Okay, so
Right.
data analytics is a vast term. Okay, there are so many things comes into data analytics.
Right.
So first, in data analytics, we used to capture data with the help of ETL tools. So suppose that someone used to design ETL tools and they used to write programs from where anyone can capture the data from ETL tools. And after
Yeah.
that, there will be SAS, Python, and R that
Right.
used to help us for data mining process. We can extract helpful data from there. And after that, we have data
Right.
visualization tools, just like Spotfire and Tableau and ClickView. So with the help of these particular tools, we can create visualizations. Okay. So suppose that we have
Right.
data in forms of Excel sheets. So if you just see that particular Excel sheet, we will not able to just catch the information that what particular thing is going on in that particular Excel sheet. If we create
Right.
visualization on that particular Excel sheet, so that will be quite helpful for anyone. So suppose if you have seen IPL matches and cricket matches, so
Yeah.
you will see a bar graph coming between those
Yeah.
match, and you can
Yeah.
see the fall of wickets, the run rate and overs, and all those things. Okay,
Yes.
so
Yes.
in just 5 minutes, so in just 5 seconds of time frame, you will all aware of that what is going on in the match and which team is lagging in the match and which are doing good like that.
Yeah.
So
Yeah.
data visualization will help you to just visualize the data and to understand the data. Okay, so
Right.
currently I'm working in that particular tool.
Okay. Okay, great. That's great.
Yeah.
So I'm sure a lot of people would want to know
Yeah.
what is the interview process at your company for your role? Like, how many rounds, interview rounds are there?
Okay, so basically, if you are a fresher, okay,
Yeah.
and if you just wanted to just go in data analytics field, so first of all, you have to learn SQL, one of the basic language, SQL.
Right.
And after that, if you have knowledge about Tableau and Spotfire a little bit, that will be
Right.
helpful for you. Okay,
Okay.
because the thing is, data visualization, we don't used to hire a fresher candidate for data
Okay.
visualization. Okay, so some
Okay.
companies used to hire a experienced candidate, but if you just
Right.
wanted to go in that particular field, so you should know basics of SQL and you should aware of the basics of tool, just like Spotfire, Tableau, or maybe the R and
Okay.
Python like that. And
Okay.
And suppose that for if you are talking about Accenture, so Accenture used to hire people, fresher from eLitmus right. and MCAT test.
Okay.
So you can just go through those particular exams and
right.
Accenture used to hire people from candidates from college placements as well. So
okay.
a student can prepare for that as well.
Right. Yeah. Okay. So now we talked about the interview process. So mm-hmm. resumes are an essential part of the hiring process.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
you also mentioned SQL and Tableau.
Yeah.
So what other than that, what else does Accenture look for in resumes?
Actually, whenever I used to see the resume for a candidate, okay. So
right.
I'm completely working in data analytics. Okay. So I will right. just see what technical skills that candidate have. Just like
okay.
he know SQL or not, he know R and Python or not, he
okay.
know the Tableau, Spotfire, those particular tools or not. Because
right.
the thing is, if resume used to work very main part in
right.
hiring process.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So suppose that any candidate is looking for a job in web designing. So
yeah.
he should mention all those technical skills, just like HTML and
right,
CSS,
right.
like that. Okay.
Yeah.
If someone is looking for a job in data analytics field, so he should focus on SQL and R and Python and all those
right.
technical languages. Okay.
Yes.
So before going for any interview, you should check your resume, whether that particular resume is for that profile or not. And
right.
In that particular way, we have to just frame our resume.
Okay.
So suppose that if it is in front of the interviewer, so
right.
there should be eye-catching technical skill should be there, like that.
Right. Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
So we talked about the general process, interview
yeah.
process at
mm-hmm.
Accenture and the
mm-hmm.
resume. So
mm-hmm.
is it possible, can you delve into the each interview round, like what
mm-hmm.
are the rounds? What do interviewers look for in each of the rounds and the levels of the question? And if there is any time between the each interview rounds?
Yeah, actually, if you are preparing for interview in any of the company, not in Accenture, so
right.
first of all, you have to focus on your written
okay.
technical skills and all that.
So right.
first round is aptitude and logical reasoning and verbal.
Okay.
So you have to focus on that. So your aptitude
right.
should be good. Logical reasoning ability should be good. Okay. And after that comes our HR round. Okay. So
right.
HR used to ask you some questions.
Okay.
And after that, technical round.
Okay.
In technical round, if you cleared that particular round, first round, so in
right.
technical round, we will just focus on your technical skills, that which languages you know, whether you
okay.
know SQL or not, in SQL
yeah.
joins and all that. Because
okay.
I have seen many candidates who used to write SQL, even they write machine learning as well in the resume, but
okay.
they are not aware of those particular things. Okay.
Right.
They
right.
used to tell us that I know only basics. Okay.
Right.
So
right.
that thing should not be happen in interview. Okay.
Yeah.
That means you are losing your marks.
Right.
So if you know any technical skills, so just mention that particular thing in your
yeah.
resume. Okay.
Yeah.
So if you are looking for a job in data analytics field, so in SQL, I used to ask just like joins and all those queries which SQL have. And
yeah.
as a fresher, we didn't get candidates who know Tableau and Spotfire. Okay. So
right.
we used to main focus, our main focus was SQL only or
okay.
and R on Python. Because in third year and fourth year also students used to prepare for R and Python. Those
okay.
are data mining skills. So
right.
we used to focus on that. And
okay.
after clearing technical interview, there was a managerial interview. So
okay.
in managerial round, our manager used to ask questions from just like logical questions that from after 5 years, where used to you used to see yourself? And if just like I was from electronics and communication background, so my manager used to ask me that you are from EC and you want to jump into IT field. Okay.
Yeah.
So why sudden things happen?
Right.
Okay. Why you're not trying in electronics field? So you should prepare all those things before the interview only. Because you should have answers for all those things. Okay.
Right.
So resume building and preparing each for each and every round is more important before going for any interview.
That's true. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So now that we've delved into the interview process in detail, I'm sure a lot of aspiring candidates would want to know, how do you prepare for a role of an analyst? Like tips, and what area should the candidates focus on?
Yeah, actually the thing is, when I was in fourth year, I didn't got college placement. Okay. So for that, after that, I just went to Bangalore. Because Bangalore is the hub of IT industry and all that. So I just went for one coaching. So at that time, I was not aware of all the technologies. I was just know Java, SQL, and testing. Okay. But there I got to know that, oh, there is data analytics field, there is big data, there is Hadoop, there is CSS and HTML as well.
Right.
So first of all, we have to just focus on our interests. So in which field we have to just start our career. Okay.
Yeah.
And after that, we have to just prepare a list that for those particular fields, which companies are working, just like Accenture, TCS, Capgemini, these are big giants. Okay. So they used to work on all the technologies. Okay.
Okay.
So you have to just prepare that. And after that, you have to work on your written skills, just like aptitude questions, logical reasoning, verbal.
Yeah.
Because the first round is that particular thing. Okay.
Right.
After completing first round only, you will able to just face technical interview questions.
Right. Okay.
So you have to prepare for that as well. And in technical interview can ask you anything from your resume. Okay.
Right.
So you have to prepare for, if you're a fresher, so for fresher, you have to prepare your technical skill as well as what you learned in your college. Just like minor project, major project, industrial trainings and all that. And for experienced candidate, what is the work process you have faced in your previous company? Okay.
Right.
So there is a work process. So you have to prepare that particular thing for experience role. Okay.
Right. Okay.
And that are the major thing, because what happened if we are facing any interview? So before interview, we used to think that we know maximum of the things, and even we know the answers as well. But in front of interviewer, we used to just confused of what should we know in our mind.
Yeah.
We have the answer, but we don't know how to speak that particular thing.
Yeah.
So before the interview, we have to prepare for that as well.
Right. Yeah. So like no matter how much we prepare, it all boils down to how you perform in the interview. If you don't perform, it could make or break your application, basically.
Okay.
So and you also mentioned about how some people include technologies, but they are not aware, they don't have enough knowledge about it. So what are some common mistakes that you have seen that candidates have made in the so many years of your experience, and what are some tips which you can give to avoid these mistakes that they make?
Actually the thing is, suppose that I am hiring for data analytics field, okay, and if I got two resumes, one know SQL, R, Python, all the technologies which are related to data analytics, and one resume have CSS, HTML, testing, all those things. So maybe all those things, all those technologies are important in market, but they are not important for me. What is important for me is SQL and R, Python, like that.
Right.
Okay. So I will focus on that particular candidate more as compared to candidate B.
Okay.
So before entering for any interview and before applying for interview, just look at your resume. What skills you have mentioned? Did you know about that or not? Because right now in market, machine learning and AI there is a boom, okay, and if I don't know anything about that, just because AI is booming, so I will write AI. So that will not work in interview, because interviewer will ask you what is AI and you don't know each and everything. Like you can't say Alexa, Alexa is based upon AI and all that, because you should know each and everything about that. Okay. So before applying for any interview, just look at your resume and what technical skills they are demanding and what technical skills you have mentioned in your resume. And the second thing is, you should know how to just throw your answers. Okay. Just like, suppose that in SQL we have joins, okay, inner join, outer join, cell join, okay, but you don't know how, what is the work of inner join. You know what inner join actually do, okay, but you don't know the correct definitions and all that, so that will create confusion in front of interviewer, okay. So mainly you should know how to explain all those things correctly, because nowadays in COVID situation we used to face virtual interviews, okay, so we can't write each and everything on pen and paper and all that, so we have to speak, okay, so we have to prepare for that as well.
So you're saying that the candidate has to work on the verbal skills as well. But how will the candidate know that he or she is going on the right path? How does the candidate know that he's not making these mistakes that you mentioned? Like, would you recommend them to give mock interviews? Do they help? And how do you think they help?
Yeah, obviously that particular thing help, mock interviews, because nowadays, because when I was giving interview back in 2015, we don't have that much facilities. Okay, so we used to just read answers and we thought that it is perfect. Okay, and we used to go for an interview. But there we used to get confused. So what to say for that particular question and what to say for that particular question. And mock interviews will help you because you are facing real interview challenges. Okay, because you don't know what is the next question and you have to prepare for that. Okay. When I was facing one interview in my time, so everything was good. 70% chances of my selections were there. And interview asked me that one logical question. He asked me, there is a glass of water and you don't have any measurement and you have to just throw water outside and it should be 50% of the water should be remaining in the glass. And after listening that question, I was just confused that how to answer, what will be my approach. Okay. So with the help of mock interviews, you will able to face real interview challenges and you will get to know that in which areas you are lacking. Okay, so that particular thing will help you in mock interviews. And in mock interviews, a real candidate who faced all these particular rounds and he is already sitting in that particular company, so he is taking your interview. Okay. So that will be helpful for the candidates, in my opinion.
So, but now, nowadays, due to COVID, all the interviews are being conducted online. So are there any special tips that the candidates should keep in mind when it comes to virtual interviews?
For virtual interview, just like, your connection should be proper, because I have faced so many interviews and where internet connectivity was not that much good. Okay. So suppose that your interview is going on, so, and your connectivity is not good. So that will just mess up your full interview. Okay. Because the thing is, we used to get very less chance for interview. Okay. And in this COVID crisis, if you are getting one chance, so just full prepared for that. Okay. And if you are going through mock interviews, that will be helpful for you. Okay. Because you already know what will be the frame of interview. Okay. Because interview start with tell me about yourself and all those things.
Right.
So if you are just going through mock interviews, so you are aware of all the questions that what should I have to speak for that particular right. question and what right. should be I speak for that particular question like yeah. that. And if candidates are applying for online interviews, so I think LinkedIn is the best platform. You can just okay. reach out to any company HR if any right. job opening is there yeah. and from there you can apply for that particular job. So
okay.
this will be, and I already mentioned resume part.
Right.
Yeah. So these particular things you can just focus on.
Okay. Great. Yeah. Yeah. So lastly, to conclude, what are some tips that you would give to all the candidates who are aspiring to become an analyst or they are aspiring to work at Accenture?
Yeah. If anyone is looking for a job in field of analytics, okay. Yeah. So you should able to read the data. Okay.
Right.
Because what data is doing, okay, so right. because here we used to work on a visualization tool, okay,
yeah.
so there are so many tools in market for visualization, okay,
right.
and there are so many technical skills just like R, Python, SAS, and Informatica tools just like ETL, okay,
right.
but the basic language is SQL, so you should know little bit about each and every tool, okay,
okay.
and what a data analytics or data scientists used to do in their job. So
right.
you should be aware of that
particular okay.
things. Because in interview, if any candidate is fresher and if he or she knows the basics of each and everything, so their probability getting selected is very high. Okay.
Right.
Because the thing is, if I am hiring someone for Spotfire or Tableau and the candidates already aware of that particular tool, okay,
right.
so the probability of that particular candidate will be
yeah.
high
because yeah.
the thing is he already aware of that particular tool. So, and already we are in COVID crisis, so we are
right.
not sitting in office and we can't just give
yeah.
trainings. Okay.
Yeah.
So that will be helpful for us.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Great.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, Akash, for sharing that with us. I
yeah.
am sure it will be really helpful for all the candidates. And thank you so much for joining.
Yeah, thanks, Rutuja, for inviting me for this interview.